Hello there, and welcome to another Eurogamer Newscast. And this time we're talking about Zelda Tears of the Kingdom and all of the burning questions that we still have as we run up to launch. We've seen a bit of this game, we've seen more of it recently than we had previously, but still there are big chunks of information that Nintendo is keeping a big surprise for us. And there are lots of theories, as you might imagine. A lot of people are really looking forward to finding out more, and some of them are here right now. It's the Eurogamer news team. We've got Ed Nightingale.
Hello.
Victoria Kennedy.
Hello.
Liv Ngan.
Hello.
And I'm Tom Phillips. And the big question for me, which I think people have had for months and months and months, is Zelda playable? And I get that Nintendo wouldn't want to spoil something of that magnitude in a trailer before launch, but have we seen anything recently that further suggests that theory? Some people have said yes. What have we seen?
I do wonder, because of a lot of, well, I say a lot, there was more footage of Zelda in the most recent trailer going on about, like, Link, you have to find me. And is that all cutscene, or are we actually going to play with Zelda in this other place that she is? And I'm ready to be disappointed, but I'm still hopeful that we might, because of the fact that Link and her are separated, but we have seen quite a lot of shots of her with this new tribe.
They've shown her holding the sword.
Yeah, the end of the trailer is literally her holding it, and I'm like, if that's not a tease for her.
But she kind of held the sword in Breath of the Wild in the sense that she put it back in a cutscene. Oh, I really want her to be playable.
Okay, I think there are two questions here. Do we think that she's going to be playable, and do we want her to be playable? And I'm pretty sure we're all on the same page with her to be playable.
Yes.
Yes. I'd love her to be playable.
Do we think that she will be? I don't know. Let's go around. Let's go around. Ed, do you think that she will be?
I mean, she already has been technically in Age of Calamity, and she is incredibly powerful in that. So I think maybe she's just too powerful. But I think she's going to be very important to the story. As Victoria said, the amount that she's in the trailer, I think we'll talk about other characters, but I think a lot of those link back to Zelda. At the very end of the trailer, it's got Zelda's lullaby at the very, very end. So I think that a lot of it is going to be her story, but I think it's going to be from the perspective of Link saving her as opposed to us playing as her.
So if you were to rank the percentage likelihood that Zelda is playable, where would you put that?
I think that there's a possibility because of what I think they've teased, but I don't think that they'll do it. So I'd say kind of 60-40 no.
Okay, 60% no.
That's still quite right. Like
Victoria,
high,
what do you think?
I'm more optimistic than Ed, so I'm going to say 70-30.
Wow.
I think it's time that Zelda is playable. Definitely. I don't think that she's going to be as much of a playable character as I first hoped. But I still do think there will be elements, even if it's more like puzzle solving and less combat. So I think there still will be something of her in this. I realize we're going to talk about this potential other tribe potentially later. So, but I think where she is, she's obviously not with Link. She's obviously pivotal to the story. So I think there will be some kind of exploration puzzle element with her, even if it's not full on combat gameplay.
I think that's fair. Yeah. So she'll appear as like a support character, as she has done in the past. You know, she turns up with her light arrows and helps Link save the day. Liv, what do you think? Do you think Zelda will be playable?
I'm like the complete opposite end of the spectrum. I think like 10% she will be playable. She won't. But I do agree that if she is playable, I think it will be a really short puzzly exploration slight bit. So, but I would really love her to be playable. But I just don't trust Nintendo to do that.
I think I agree with Liv. I I hear what you're saying, that it's definitely time. I would love it. I really, really would. And if you ask me the question, like, do I want it to be the case? Yes, I do. But is it going to happen? I just think the style of game the Breath of the Wild was and was so successful at, they're going to do the same thing here. And that's very difficult to do when you're switching between characters, especially when you're like building things together with an inventory of stuff and exploring a big world. And
well, see, I was kind of picturing it potentially happening at, so you know how in Breath of the Wild you found like memories and things? I assume we can talk Breath of the Wild spoilers in this chat. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yeah.
So, So, in my mind, whenever I was picturing her doing any kind of Zelda gameplay, it would be after you get to a point like where you find a memory, and then there'll be like a little segment of something happening. So it's not necessarily going to break up the open world exploration. It'll only happen if you find a certain thing within the world, and then it'll kind of be a little bit of gameplay after that sort of section. Which I think they did something similar, and I want to say it's like Paper Mario, was it Paper Mario? With Peach, where at the end of a certain point you then have a little section with Peach.
Yeah.
I think it was Paper Mario.
Yeah, Passenger Door.
So, I'm picturing it kind of like that. So it's not going to be something that you're, it's not going to be like you're forced into a linear storyline. There'll still be an exploration element, but you can trigger a gameplay section with Zelda, if it happens at all.
I guess having her separated allows you to have those sort of small discrete little sections, like if she is trapped underground somewhere, then maybe it's her in some caves or something like that.
Well, that's the thing, I'm kind of more interested, well, not more interested, but I'm interested to know where she is, because we keep seeing this clip of her falling down into a cavern and Link reaching for her, and then whenever we see her, she's got her shorter hair, she's with this other tribe, presumably the Zonai, she's got the same earrings. So I'm wondering, like, where is she, but also when is she?
Ooh, when?
She's fallen so hard that she's gone back in time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe.
See, yeah, I think the Zonai tribe have definitely done something with her during that fall. Do you want me to go into a big theory I have, or not really?
Sure.
Okay, so you know how in the first trailer we saw that Ganondorf was being like held by that hand under the thing, and obviously like that hand then saved Link and released Ganon potentially. So I reckon that they're obviously in charge of some kind of like time space, like they have some kind of power that they can control this, and that we've seen like their like robot constructs and things in the sky. I reckon they saved, so Link obviously got like sent packing to sort out whatever has just gone down. They then saved Zelda and took her back to try and sort something out in the past to help Link in the present. This is my theory. Because the hand that you see going onto Zelda's shoulder in the most recent trailer is a very similar styling to the hand that was holding down Ganondorf in the first trailer.
I would love time travel, or like multiple Links and Zeldas. There to be some sort of in-game acknowledgement of the fact that there are multiple incarnations of Link and Zelda over time, and to sort of play them, because in previous games there's that knight who turns up who teaches you cool stuff, and that is always supposed to be an old version of Link helping
the next generation. That's Hero of Time. That's Ocarina of Time's Link in. I think it's actually now canon in Twilight Princess. The guy that saves you is the Ocarina of Time Link that wasn't the hero.
Yeah. So they've sort of played with that idea in the past, but to have an expanded version of that would be really cool.
See, I think that's where the story is kind of going, because if you look at the Zelda timeline, Breath of the Wild is right at the end, and Skyward Sword is at the start, and there are so many references to Skyward Sword in this, in terms of sort of Ganondorf looking very demise-esque in certain ways. So much happening up in the sky and falling and all this sort of stuff that I feel like they are trying to link them. And obviously one of the most important things is the Ouroboros, which is the symbol of the game, which symbolizes cycles and eternity. And I feel like there's going to be some sort of time travel element where it's linking back to what happened in Skyward Sword, or it's referencing Hylia, whatever her name is, and all that kind of stuff that happened. And so it's kind of turning the timeline into a circle. And so the whole thing is sort of referencing cycles. That's my thinking, like, hence why they've got the Ouroboros as the symbol.
Mm-hmm. I really love that idea.
That's the theory I'm going for as well.
So many of the Zelda games follow the similar structure, and, you know, of course that's just because Nintendo likes a certain structure for a Zelda game, but also you can headcanon it to be, well, this is sort of the cycle that keeps repeating, right? Ganondorf rises, Link turns up, defeats him, repeat. But I love the idea that beyond that, we're seeing a return to the sort of the Skyloft era, where there's this mysterious, like, there is a islands in the sky, and then there's an overworld. Although much better than Skyward Sword, because Skyward Sword didn't have an overworld.
I also feel like that would free Nintendo from the timeline a bit, because I sort of feel like that's got added in as all these games have come and they've said, oh, wait, there's a timeline. And I feel like it's just very forced. And now whenever a new game comes out, it's, oh, well, where does it fit in the timeline? And I don't personally care about the timeline. Like, I'd like each Zelda game individually. I don't feel like they need to be in a timeline. But if you turn the timeline into a circle, it kind of makes it pointless. And then you can just go off and do whatever you want afterwards. So I feel like it sort of ties the games up, but then allows Nintendo to go off and do something else later, because they don't have to worry about where does it fit in the timeline, because the timeline is a circle.
I love that we found
chaos
a way
is a ladder.
We found a way to turn Nintendo's ridiculously complicated three-pronged Zelda timeline into a new shape.
Where does, in the timeline as it exists currently, where does Twilight Princess come in? I can't actually remember, because I'm getting a lot of Twilight Princess vibes also from what they have shown so far for Tears of the Kingdom.
Well, it's sat towards the latter end of one of the three prongs.
One of the three prongs.
But I can't, off the top of my head, remember which of those three prongs it is.
It's the one wherever Ocarina of Time's Link is not a hero of time. But I'm getting a lot of, like, so I know that there have been talk about, like, the Zonai tribe being in this game because of the symbology, you know, with all the sort of spiraling and things on buildings, etc. And I still have a feeling that there's that big circular rock structure that was quite prominently featured in the most recent trailer. You could see it on the skyline, even the shots where it wasn't the main focus, it was still, like, in the skyline. And I really feel like that's got something to do with the Mirror of Twilight. And then, like, the Zonai being related to the Twilly? I don't know how you'd say their names. Twilight. Oh, I have so many theories.
So
Twilight Princess comes after Majora's Mask, which is the middle timeline where the hero is triumphant and it's continuing with Child Link.
Mm. Here we go. Yeah, let's make it a circle. I think that'll be easier for everyone.
The thing is, though, if you make it a circle, does it not then force you to have to make everything the same, like, the same structure? You have to continue, you know, the Ganondorf rises and then Link and Zelda defeat him cycle, right?
Well, maybe that becomes one cycle, and then the next game on Switch 2 will be a new cycle and is completely separate because they've completed it.
Maybe in that cycle we actually get to play as Zelda.
Yeah,
that's the Zelda cycle. There'll be the Legend of Link.
The Legend of Link. Zelda's Adventure.
And then we get
Zelda's Awakening.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Perfect.
And then we get the Ganon cycle, where Ganondorf is actually a good guy.
Good.
Yeah.
Or is
and then that makes
cycle
a Triforce. And then there's the what's in the middle that they all combine to.
What is the hole in the middle?
We mentioned the Zonai. If you're not a Zelda buff, you probably don't know who the Zonai are. And to be honest, I don't really know. We don't really know very much, do we? What do we know about the Zonai, Victoria?
Well, not very much. So in Breath of the Wild, there are the Zonai ruins that you can come across in the Farron region. I think it's the Farron region, the more tropical-looking area. And there have been theories about who the Zonai are, because then you can get the barbarian armor, I think it's called. Like, I think you get that from the labyrinths. don't count on me as your Breath of the Wild walkthrough, I should say. Anyway, they talk about how it was like related to this tribe, etc., etc. And there are theories that the Zonai tribe that are referenced in Breath of the Wild are the interlopers, who were Hylians that broke away from the good Hyrule tribe and became the Twili in Twilight Princess. And the reason people are wondering if the Zonai and the Twili Twilight are the same is because if you look in Twilight Princess's Tower of Twilight, the last area anyway, there's a lot of the sort of spiral symbology, which has also been shown on the Zonai ruins in Breath of the Wild. And then in the more recent trailers, because I think in the gameplay trailer before and the most recent sort of story trailer, you can see that symbology again, and the constructs in the sky also dropped Zonai charge. So that's where the Zonai come in. It's all very speculatory, though, at the moment. All of what I've just said is kind of what people have put together themselves, rather than Nintendo actually saying the Zonai are related to the Twili and this is what they've done. I hope that helps.
Well, it's certainly something to think about, and we won't know the answer until the game comes out.
I think Zelda's with the Zonai.
I think Zelda's with the Zonai,
and I think the guy with the hand you mentioned on her shoulder, I think, is Zonai. I think the other, I mean, maybe we'll talk about it next, but there are some other characters, new characters, that I suspect are Zonai.
Yes.
There's a blonde.
There's a blonde, and I think that's some kind of Zonai Zelda equivalent or counterpart.
Yes. Is this blonde person Zelda, or is it someone who's like a different version of Zelda?
So I think it's a different version of Zelda, and I think it might be the Zelda that helps heal Calamity Ganon all the way back 10,000 years prior to the events of Breath of the Wild. That's my theory at the moment.
I love that theory.
And so that's another reason, like, obviously Ed's already mentioned time travel. I think Zelda's in the past to the point where Calamity Ganon was being sealed.
Or if she's not in the past, maybe this is where the Zonai have been living underground, where we see Zelda falling down to. And they've just been down there the whole time. And Zelda's just been chilling. Old Zelda has just been chilling. And Zelda just goes to meet her. I like the idea that, well, like, if you're a Nintendo and you're trying to build out the Breath of the Wild world, you know, what can you do? Well, you say, okay, so here's Hyrule, and we've changed it a bit, but we put the Sky Islands in. What else can we do? Well, underneath, all along, there was this other civilization.
But it's, and you can go down there.
Layers of layers of layers. Worlds within worlds.
But their world's bright, so I'm not sure if they're underground or not, which is why I think they've taken her out of the caverns. Because she's not in... It is magic. but
they're using their Zonai charges.
Yeah.
To charge things.
Yeah, maybe power their light sources to make some kind of UV sun lamp.
I think the other theory is that she might be the goddess. Is it Hylia or Hylia? I never know.
I'd say Hylia.
Hylia, like Hyrule, that's how I've always said it.
That's Hylia likely.
Yes. So there's a theory that it's her as well, because there is a different look to sort of, she doesn't look as human.
So the ears are, they remind me quite like rabbity almost.
And then in the previous trailer with the sort of mural, there's obviously that figure with the big ears and the tears around, and I don't know if that's that blonde character, or is it the man? Is it the other woman who might be a Zonai? I think it relates to all of that. Because that mural seems to be... It's obviously similar to the style of Breath of the Wild, where they're recounting what happened 10,000 years ago. Which is why I think, again, as with you, Vittoria, I think it links back to what happened 10,000 years ago. I don't know.
Yeah, I think that... Yeah, the tribe's obviously very important, along with Zelda's story being very important. And to be honest, what we've seen of Link so far, he feels more like a chess piece rather than actually the main point. Like, I definitely think it's going to be a much more lore-based game than Breath of the Wild was.
Hmm.
Obviously, Link is still going to be very important, being the player character, for what we assume, at least the most part. But
for all of it.
Shush.
Well, also, are there multiple Links? Because we've seen there's like a Link with longer hair and a different outfit. Is that the same Link? Or does this tie into the cycles and the time travel? Is it an older Link that you're also playing as?
Maybe there's just a barbershop where you can go and get your hair cut.
All that.
Seeing... I really just like the idea of, you know, them going full on with kind of the outfits and accessories and letting you, like, let you, like...
customize your Link.
Choose, like, Link's, like, helmets and stuff. That's just, that's just, that would just be really fun.
Do we think that all of the gear that you had in the previous game, a lot of it we've seen, but do you think Link is going to have access to that from the start? Or is that going to, you're going to need to go find it all again?
I have theories. Oh, I how much can I say from what I've read online that other people might not have read?
Say whatever you want. Okay, I mean, so, we're all in the same boat. We don't know the answers.
Well, so Nintendo have said where the game will start. And so I'm picturing that as being like the Great Plateau equivalent, and like your little training area. And then I think you'll kind of get... So you know in Breath of the Wild how you did the Great Plateau and then you went and met with the king and he told you about what happened. So I think you're going to start completely weaponless, etc. Then you'll have to complete this training area, Great Plateau equivalent. Something will then happen where they'll then tell you about why you're suddenly equipmentless, etc. And I think that will cut to the cavern scene with Zelda getting dropped down and that bit of Ganondorf being released. And then I think the game will then continue after that sort of like base story layer has been made. So I don't think you'll start with stuff because of what happened in the cavern.
I mean, I think you'll start with the Master Sword.
Well, yeah. You might start with a bit of stuff, but I think they'll probably do a Metroid. You know, Metroid is the same Samus every time, but you always have to get the same items. So there's always some sort of catastrophe that happens at the start that strips her of all of her abilities. And I think they'll have something like that, whether that is falling down the cavern or whatever else. But there'll be something that strips him of abilities, which then allows them to have a clean slate. Not a Sheikah slate, but a clean slate to build up on.
What will they have instead of the Sheikah slate? Oh, it's the arms, isn't it? Of course, we've seen it in the trailers. Yeah, him using his, I keep saying rewind ability, it's not called that at all, but the undo thing with his arm.
What do you all think of fusing?
I think it looks amazing. I'm so excited. Like, do you see the one of him with like his massive Zweihander sword and then his little shield popped onto the blade? And then the mushroom that could be like a spore cloud missile, whatever. I think it looks, it was, I did see someone saying it was a little bit like that Crash Bandicoot Bits and Bobs or whatever it was called.
Banjo-Kazooie,
that was it. Lots of bobs, thank you. I mean, you knew what I meant. And I just think it looks great fun. And then the Ultra Hand where you can make your vehicles. And that little clip that they showed in the most recent trailer where Link was essentially riding a huge cinder block into battle. I just think it looks like creativity is going to be such a big focus.
I like it because I think that it will... everyone complained about durability in Breath of the Wild. And I think if this stuff breaks now with the fuse system... It's not the end of the world because you are going to want to be experimental. You're going to want to be trying out different things and you're not going to want to necessarily have a sword with a orange on it forever, you know. You know, you want to give it a go and then try it. And, you know, if the orange breaks, oh no, you want to stick a mushroom on it and see what happens then. So,
have you seen the sort of artwork that's gone around and someone's made Link invincible by putting a shield with a chicken on the or cuckoo on the front? And I just think that's amazing.
Oh god, that is the ultimate weapon.
Yeah.
the cloud of cuckoos just come in.
Well, what happens though if it backfires and they actually attack Link instead? Because they're like, hey, like, screw you for sticking me on a shield.
As I say, I mean, I'm not sure the cuckoo would be delighted about being fused with a shield. If it was done in a humane way, I don't know.
Magic.
Yeah. I'd say I'm a little bit less enthusiastic about the fusion stuff. I can see why they've done it, because people have experimented so much with Breath of the Wild. And it's interesting that there are so many different ways of solving puzzles. And it feels like they're sort of leaning into that a lot more with experimentation. But that's not really why I play Zelda games. And I kind of like having, like, right, here's your set of equipment, and now you have to solve puzzles thinking of ways to use that. As opposed to just picking up random things and fusing them together to see what happens. Like, I'm just not a very creative person. Like, I don't play Minecraft. I don't play The Sims. Like, I don't like crafting and building in games. It's just not my thing, personally. So I can see why they've done it. And I think, to Tom's point, it definitely helps with the durability argument. But I would rather have a set of items that you then work with.
In Breath of the Wild, then, did you... So I got really into the cooking because I wanted to see what different things would do when put together. Did you not really get into the cooking, making stamina meals and things in Breath of the Wild?
I love cooking and food, so I still did that. but that's kind of, oh, I've got all these extra monster parts or whatever, so let's throw them together and see what happens. And usually you get something good from it, so it's fine. But when it comes to weapons and fusing stuff and the idea of then building like these huge vehicles and stuff, it's just, it feels very out there to me for a Zelda game. And I'm still not quite sure how I feel about that and how I feel about that being integrated into this world. It just, like, we laugh about the big cinder block, as you said, but it's also a bit silly. Or like Link in a flying car. It's just not what I expect from Zelda.
Did feel weird when they gave Link a motorcycle in the DLC.
That was weird, yeah.
That was a bit like, oh, okay.
It's interesting, isn't it? It's not how Zelda games used to be, but when you look back at what was really popular in Breath of the Wild, it was all of those videos where people worked out crazy things to do with the game systems and the tools that it gave you, like climbing on top of a boulder and launching it all the way to Hyrule Castle from the plateau and killing Ganon in one hit, you know, that kind of thing. And I think that it's really interesting to see that Nintendo have picked up on that, and the amount of freedom and flexibility that the fuse system gives, I think, is meant to prompt those videos, which will keep people interested in playing the game beyond, you know, having a set solution to a puzzle that gets put in a walkthrough and everyone does because they've picked up the item from the dungeon that solves that thing, and then that's it.
I just hope that we don't have to experiment too much, like a small amount of it and fusing stuff, because, oh, this weapon's broken and here's a twig and now I can do that. That's fun. But what I don't want is, oh, to solve this puzzle you have to construct boom 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 and whatever. Like, it's a fun optional thing, but I wouldn't want it to be completely necessary to every part of the game necessarily.
Yeah, I hope it's more included. Like, I think it looks like a lot of fun, but I hope that is kind of why it's there. It's not going to be a key, you know, because, I mean, Breath of the Wild was so popular also because of its flexibility. Like you said, people played in so many different ways. They went straight to Ganon on the back of a rock, or, you know, fought him with just a stick. So I think if they made it that you had to equip a certain weapon to fight a certain thing, that would be more limiting than I think it should be, given the open worldness and experimentation that was in Breath of the Wild. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, I agree. I think when it's implemented, I hope it's implemented as an extension to creation rather than trying to pigeonhole gameplay.
Yeah. Like, I wasn't, after that gameplay reveal, I was excited to think, okay, this is what's new, but I wasn't jumping for joy. And then the more recent trailer that's much, much more story focused and then has all these sort of lore implications, as we've already talked about, that for me is much more exciting. And that's why I want to play this game, is because I want to know what the story is. It feels like, again, one of the criticisms of Breath of the Wild was that there wasn't enough story because it was all the flashbacks only, and they were very easy to miss. And it feels like they're trying to have a bit more of a balance of, okay, here's an open world, and here's all this creativity, but then we're also going to give you a lot more story and lore. And it's that second bit that excites me a lot more.
Well, as we look to wrap up, there's one more question that I want to ask you all, and it is tied into story and lore a bit. Is Ganon good?
No.
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 Why would he ever be good?
I wrote a theory piece yesterday, and I've seen so many people discussing Ganondorf hero. I don't think so, no. I think that would be even more far out for Nintendo to do than playable Zelda.
Why do people think that that's a thing, Victoria, for people who haven't read your piece yet?
Well, it all comes back to the tapestry which was shown in Breath of the Wild. So when Impa's explained to Link about what happened, the figure depicted as the hero has red hair and a large nose. That's literally it. And I still believe they've done that just to separate Link from other characters on the tapestry as well, which are also depicted in blue, like it's the elephant Var. I keep saying Vandaboris, but it's the camel. Anyway, the elephant is blue. And so I think they had to make Link a different colour to that, so he was in his own colour. But people believe that that was a version of Ganondorf fighting Calamity Ganon because of the red hair.
It just doesn't make sense to me.
I just don't see it. And then there's the Zonai, or who we assume is a Zonai character, whose face we haven't seen, and he had a boar, I don't know if it was a necklace, but some kind of like boar adornment on his chest piece. And obviously Ganon's... An abornment, exactly, yeah. Everyone is now wondering if that's Ganondorf, sorry, because of the fact that he's got this boar chest piece, which Ganon in his beast form is generally depicted as some kind of boar. But I don't
Or
think
is
so.
Ganondorf just a Zonai that went bad?
Maybe. But then I think that's more likely to be the other sort of potential Zonai character that we saw that we know nothing about. It was just a darker looking Zonai in the sense of just the look of evil on him and like the malice in the background.
Do we think Ganondorf's going to go Thanos collecting the tears of the kingdom?
I think that's more Probably. Likely. That's yeah. I think a more likely theory, and I think the tears are connected to dungeons, dare I say it. I hope they are. But
I would love that.
Yeah.
But then we've seen them on the champions, and I'm wondering if they are going to be companions on the journey. But then do you collect the Tears of the Kingdom, or do they get stolen one by one?
Well, we don't know where those... So we see the tears in the trailer, but you might have to like salvage a tear from a dungeon. And then at that point, the champion will be imbued with the power of the tear and able to fight alongside you, like the sages in Ocarina of Time, where you get the medallions from them.
That would be cool.
Oh, I'm very excited, everyone.
It's all connected. Well, there's not long to wait until it arrives. Less than a month now, which is very exciting. And then we'll know the answers to all of these questions and see if Zelda is playable or not. Thanks for joining us if you made it this far. Ed, where can people find you on Twitter?
You can find me at @ed_knights.
Victoria?
I am Little Chop Shop Gal.
And Liv?
I am at Just Cast Holy.
And I'm at Tom Phillips EG. Thanks for watching, everyone. Happy theorising. We'll see you next time. Bye for now.
See you then.
Bye.